The short-tailed shearwater looks run-of-the-mill. It's brown, has wings, and a fish-catching bill. This seabird is common, its number excessive. But commonness doesn't imply unimpressive. See, shearwaters cope with a vast oscillation, latitudinal, annual, Pacific migration. Our story begins in Australia's Bass Strait, on this group of islands where shearwaters mate. But now it is March, the chick rearing done, so it's time to take flight, to follow the sun. Before flying north, we need fuel for the flight, so instead let's fly south before winter's long night. The Antarctic coast teems with fish, squid and krill. The birds spend a month here eating their fill. The shearwaters gorge on their yearly return, but it's April, the weather is starting to turn. Before it gets too cold, the birds depart their southern base. Now we're heading north, the shorttails reach a rapid pace. Past the snowy mountains of New Zealand's southern tip, the shorttails fang it northwards on this expeditious trip. Soaring over Vanuatu, pressing ever north, every year these seabirds fly this journey back and forth. Our shorttails cross the globe's equator by the start of May. The journey from the south is only on its seventh day. At Nauru, turn slightly west and go after the sun. One more week of flying and the first leg will be done. Heading past Japan, the shorttails see the end in sight. Above Hokkaido, gliding down, we finally alight. A fortnight of flying, birds hungry for prey. The Sea of Okhotsk is an ocean buffet. For many, this sea yields enough of a feast. Others aren't sated until they head east. So eastwards we go to find fish stocks anew, to the Bering Sea tinted a sapphire hue. Adventurous birds fly a northerly course. The Chukchi Sea offers an ample resource. But while shearwaters gorge eating bountiful krill, October brings with it a bit of a chill. See, 5 months have passed and the instinct kicks in, the instinct to migrate that comes from within. The race for the equator starts as birds as one take wing, another swift migration for the warmth of southern spring. Farewell to the Aleutians hemming in the Bering Sea, these birds have honed their navigation to a fine degree. Racing through the North Pacific beats the dwindling light, see Hawaii and keep west to expedite the flight. The Earth's equator nears when shorttails reach their seventh day, the comfort of the nesting burrows 10 more days away. Turning slightly west at Fiji keeps the southern trend, passing Norfolk Island as the journey nears its end. At last Australia's eastern coast comes sharply into view, descending, slowing, coming down, the journey's nearly through. The shearwaters land by their last season's nest. With this passage completed, it's time for a rest. The next year will bring another commute of this Antarctic-Arctic long migratory route.